the carnivorous aircrafts. Item number, SCP-9001. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. Captured SCP-9001 specimens are to be kept in large stainless steel aircraft hangars that match the SCP-9001 specimen size. Each specimen must be kept at different site locations to prevent an escape event. Communicating with SCP-9001 specimens must be approved by Level 4 personnel. SCP-9001 specimens are to be fed 4 livestock animals each day and given fuel every 3 days. If any large SCP-9001 specimens are to escape, the site from which they escape is to be immediately locked down, and NTF and MTF personnel are to immediately be dispatched to either catch the SCP-9001 specimen or terminate it. Description: most SCP-9001 specimens take the appearance of a form of man-made aircraft, such as jets, planes, and helicopters. In rare cases, some have even taken the form of drones and other remote control flying objects. The first SCP-9001 specimen was found beside a house in 19-blank, Oklahoma, after the homeowner reported that a jet ate his wife. SCP-9001 was found feasting upon blank, the homeowner's wife. The original specimen was caught and put in containment, but more SCP-9001 specimens were reported. SCP-9001 has internal organs and bones that are adapted to match that of the flying object they are taking the form of. SCP-9001 specimens do not have eyes, but have security cameras instead that are behind the windscreen. The cameras are not normally visible and are only visible on the drone models, which only have one camera. The cameras are attached to wires and an optical nerve, similar to organic entities. SCP-9001 specimens have their own hunting techniques, with larger ones hunting like large modern-day birds, swooping down and grabbing their prey in their mouths, while smaller ones like the drones are scavengers and eat carrion. SCP-9001 specimens will seek out fuel, and when they find it, an organ appendage, similar to that of an intestine, will come out of the fuel tank and puncture the fuel source, draining the fuel from it. SCP-9001 mouth placements can vary depending on the model, with large SCP-9001 specimens having a jaw that folds out from the bottom of the aircraft nose, and the drones having mouths that fold out from underneath. SCP-9001 specimens are extremely aggressive and feed on humans and other medium to large animals. SCP-9001 specimens hunt in groups, with most groups having 5 to 15 specimens. Male SCP-9001 specimens are larger than female SCP-9001 specimens. SCP-9001 specimens rapidly reproduce and will fly to a populated area and drop 2 to 6 cluster bombs, which will explode, and a young SCP-9001 specimen will emerge, with the model mostly varying on the mother or father's aircraft model, sometimes making a mix of the two or a totally different model altogether. The young SCP-9001 specimens will learn to fly within 10 minutes and gain sexual maturity within 12 days. SCP-9001 specimens live for 10 years, 13 at most. The largest SCP-9001 specimen took the form of an Antonov and 225 Maria plane. The large SCP-9001 specimen is currently in Foundation custody at site blank. SCP-9001 specimens communicate to each other through Morse code and engine sounds. Personnel have attempted to communicate with SCP-9001 specimens with devices that translate English to Morse code, with no progress so far. When SCP-9001 specimens die, they spin at a high speed and fall to the ground, and will kill a desired target, then explode. SCP-9001 specimens show intelligence similar to that of a human, with most specimens targeting large populated areas for feeding SCP-9001. Attempts to tame SCP-9001 specimens or interact with them have not been effective. SCP-9001 specimens are adapted to live in radioactive environments, as well as high and low temperature climates. SCP-9001 specimens will knock manned aircrafts out of the sky and attack them with hostility. How they can distinguish a real aircraft from another SCP-9001 specimen is unknown as of now.